लेट्स डिस्कस अबाउट लिमिटिंग रिएजेंट्स, वन वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट फिनोमिना इन केमिस्ट्री, पर्टिकुलरली फॉर कैलकुलेशन पर्पस ऑफ स्टोइकोमेट्रिक थिंग्स। बिफोर डिस्कसिंग अबाउट लिमिटिंग रिएजेंट प्रॉब्लम्स, लेट्स टेक सम सिंपल एग्जांपल्स। दिस इज लक्ष्मा रेड्डी, केमिस्ट्री। यू कैन रेज योर डाउट्स, यू कैन सेंड योर डाउट्स ऑन व्हाट्सएप 8904674423। राइट, सो फॉर एग्जाम्पल, you and your friend went to a bakery. You have full of money, but there is only one chocolate which you deserve, which you require, which you desire. Only one chocolate is there. You both are present, you need one chocolate each minimum. There are full of money, that's not an issue, but there is only one chocolate. That means here you have to buy only one chocolate. So in this case, the chocolate is the limiting reagent. The same case we'll take, you and your friend again. This time you have only 50 rupees, but now, as you visited the shop last time, that fellow brought many chocolates, so only one Dairy Milk Circle you can buy, but there are many chocolates in the shop. So chocolates are number of, you both are present, but only 50 rupees is there. In this situation, the 50 rupees is the limiting reagent. In the previous case, one chocolate was there, that is limiting reagent. In this case, money is the limiting reagent. Now, one more time, you are alone and you only went there. Again, pocket full money, plenty of chocolates, but you are alone. So you can eat only one chocolate. That means in this case, you are the limiting reagent. So in all these kind of cases, you can take one simple point that in all the cases you are buying only one chocolate. The reason is very, very, very simple. Because in the first case, the chocolate is the limiting reagent. Second case, money is the limiting reagent. Third case, you are the limiting reagent. Overall, you are buying only one chocolate. So it's very simple. Calculate the problem according to limiting reagent whenever two reactants are given. So I'll give you one simple example. Find the mass of ammonia formed when 3 gram hydrogen reacts with 28 grams of nitrogen. See the question again. Find the mass of ammonia formed when 3 gram hydrogen reacts with 28 grams of nitrogen. N2 plus 3H2 gives rise to ammonia, that is 2NH3. This is a balanced chemical equation which we call stoichiometric equation. In this, 1 mole of nitrogen reacts with 3 moles of hydrogen. 1 mole means 28 grams of nitrogen. Reacts with 3 moles of hydrogen means 6 grams of hydrogen. As we know that hydrogen molecular mass is 2 grams, 3 moles means 6 grams. So it is clear from the equation that 28 grams of nitrogen requires 6 grams of hydrogen. Clear? 28 grams requires 6 grams of hydrogen. Now just have a look at the question. In the question it is given 28 grams of nitrogen and you mentioned only 3 grams of hydrogen. So 28 grams of nitrogen actually requires 6 grams of hydrogen, but in the problem that is given only 3 grams of hydrogen. Now by seeing the question you can say directly 28 grams of nitrogen is excess and 3 grams of hydrogen is minimum. So here the limiting reagent is hydrogen and you have to solve the question according to hydrogen. You should not solve according to nitrogen. Nitrogen is here excess and hydrogen is here limiting reagent. You can see here it is clear from the equation that 28 grams of nitrogen requires 6 grams of hydrogen, but 3 grams of hydrogen is only given with 28 grams of nitrogen. So hydrogen is in lesser amount, actually required is 6 but given is only 3, so that is in the lesser amount and hydrogen is called here limiting reagent. We have to solve according to limiting reagent and this equation we are writing here, N2 plus 3H2 gives rise to 2 ammonia. Here 3 moles of hydrogen means 6 grams of hydrogen gives 2 moles of ammonia means 2 into 17 grams, that is 34 grams of ammonia. When 6 grams of hydrogen can give 34 grams of ammonia, 3 grams gives how much? So 3 into 34 by 6, that is 17 grams of ammonia is formed. This is one very, very, very important concept that is called as limiting reagent. So first of all, you have to check which is in lesser quantity and based on that, you have to calculate the given things. All the best.